Did you know that in 1755, Barbados get hit by a tsunami? And not even for anywhere close by, it came from Lisbon. I even know where that is. So you may be wondering, if that happened ever since then, why you gotta be worried now? Well, Dr. John Latchman at the Seismic Research Center says that since 2013, the number of earthquakes in what is called the Barbados Zone has increased. And the more earthquakes that happen around Barbados, the higher the chance a tsunami can happen too. But don't worry, because by the end of this video, I can tell you what to do in the event of a tsunami and how to not end up floating from a piece of galvanized. You ever wonder if a tsunami had to hit Barbados, what it would look like? My first guess was a wave the size of the Central Bank will wipe me out and put me underwater. However, turns out that the wave gonna be probably as tall as my finger. A simulation was done by the Department of Emergency Management in association with UNESCO to figure out what it would look like if part of the West Coast had to get hit by a tsunami that's approximately 2 meters high. Now we know you're thinking, Northeast means St. Andrew, so that's probably St. Andrew people problem. Well, that ain't necessarily true, because not only would they be impacted, but the wave gonna wrap around the country and impact the West Coast as well. And anything in the water or on the shoreline can get pushed with it. I talking anything on the West Coast. That means jet skis, beach trees, Suzuki Swifts, anything that I touch getting pushed inland. All right, so I can throw this question at you. If a tsunami is coming, what should you do? Should you A, run, B, drive, or C, take your clothes off your line? Well, if you choose C, something wrong with you. But if you see a tsunami coming or hear a tsunami warning, stop what you're doing, get out your car and run. I mean run with the energy lyric got. I mean run like you're trying to catch the Fairchild Street Terminal last bus. I mean run like you hear that song from Mr. Killer. Just run. Oh wait, I didn't even tell you where you're running to. A good rule of thumb is, if you are about 30 or so meters above sea level, then you are pretty much out of the tsunami range. Also in the project done, they found some areas on the West Coast that are known as evacuation assembly points. These are the places that you can run to make sure that you are out of harm's way. To find out if a tsunami is coming, you just gotta download this app, the CapCap app. If you download the CapCap app, it can send a warning to your phone and let you know when it is you gotta run in the event of a tsunami. Here's what I was wondering though. They got over $1 billion worth of high-end infrastructure on the West Coast. If a tsunami had to come and hit the West Coast now, what we would do? Do you think that we have enough things in place to recover from a tsunami? Furthermore, in Bridgetown, where they got enough businesses, the wharf right there. So when that water rise now, what can happen? What can happen to the oil men that do business in Swan Street? What about the woman in front Cave Shepherd that's be asking for sponsors? How will Stiffy be able to carry his sheep in town? These is questions that we gotta ask ourselves if we wanna be tsunami ready. Leave a comment below and let me know what you think.